Hi Leo, welcome back to Omkara Tarot, and today we're going to be doing a sneak peek into the upcoming energies coming towards you in June now, and see how you can use these energies to have a fabulous month ahead. And these are general collective readings, Leo, will not resonate with all of you. Please keep that in mind. Take what works for you, leave the rest. So my angel spirit guides, please bless this reading for my lions and my lionesses, my Leo gang, and let's find out what energies are in store for them in June now. Thank you. So Leo, let's begin. Welcome back all my subscribers. Thank you for being here again. And if you're new here, Leo, we welcome you too. Do join us, subscribe to the channel, become part of us. We welcome you in. All right, waiting for your ships to come in, Leo. What is this with Aries and Leo? Same card, same position. Okay. Death card. Nine of Cups. Hermit. Queen of Wands. And the Nine of Swords. All right. So Leo, I think you've been waiting for a very long time. Yes, I do see the Hanged Man here. Stuck energy, just trying to take a chill pill. Maybe you've put in a lot of work. In the past, I do see you got some clarity about something. And things were pretty clear. I mean, you kind of got clear-headed, but you're still waiting for something to now come in, or you're looking towards the future now to see what else is out there. So let's see, let's clarify these cards. But before that, Leo, I'm going to take a Ganesha oracle card for you. Let's see how Lord Ganesha is going to bless you in June. So Lord Ganesha, a blessing for my Leo gang, please. A blessing for my Leo gang, please. Lord Ganesha. Blessing for my lions out there. Okay. Card I have for you here, Leo, says fulfillment. Yes. So Leo, I don't know what you're looking for, what you're waiting for, but please know if you've been stressing about it, there's a huge transformation that's coming into your life, which I think is leading you straight to your fulfillment. So put this here, and what is Leo waiting for? What's this Three of Wands? What's this Three of Wands for Leo, for June? For now, actually, this is your current energy. Or you're waiting for things to start moving. You want to end this last chapter, I think, where you've been in hermit mode. You've been stressed. You've been maybe alone. You want to get out of this stuck position in your life now. Wishing and hoping for a change of fortune, change of luck, change of the wind, basically. And here I see you. This is your current energy. Waiting for things to start moving in a fortunate manner for you. Okay? So what happened in the recent past, Spirit, for Leo to be in this state now? Ace of Swords. What happened in the recent past? Leo, you became clear about something. Yes, you became clear about something, about maybe ending a chapter. You started concentrating more on yourself. You started nurturing yourself more, taking care of business maybe, and kind of starting to protect your energy. And you became clear about maybe all the lying, cheating behavior that was going on around you maybe, or somebody did that to you. Some things came to light here, Leo, with the Ace of Swords and the Seven of Swords. You getting out of some place which was not really very good for you, completing one chapter, taking back your power, keeping yourself protected, and moving towards something that's going to make you very, very happy and very stable now. And as much as you've done all that, the clarity was there. Now I think you're just waiting. You're waiting for your ships to come in here. So Spirit, what's coming up now then in June, Spirit, for Leo? Eight of Cups. Oh, brand new journey. I told you. See, you're leaving behind all this emotional unhappiness. Aries had the same card, same position, right? So leaving something which was not good for you, which was draining you out, which was not making you happy. So you're leaving all that behind and you're going off for a fresh, brand new beginning in June, Leo. The Fool. going towards lots of happiness, lots of celebration, meeting up with like-minded people, I think. Maybe reunions happening here, I don't know what's happening, but you are leaving something which was not good for you. The clarity came a little while ago, you held your ground, now you're probably waiting for things to actually manifest and change, but in June, here's your new beginning. Here's your new beginning. You're walking away from anything that wasn't good for you. And yes, it's going to lead you to a lot of happiness here. A lot of celebrations. So, what's this death card, spirit? Death card, what's this transformation that's coming? Brand new life. Hold on to this thought, Leo. While you're waiting also, don't give up hope. That's all I can say, because I do see a big transformation coming into your life. It's going to feel like a renewal, like a rebirth of your life. Judgment. All your good karma is now going to be showing up, and you'll probably feel you've been born again. So one more spirit for the death card and the judgment card. Yeah, here you are sitting in your seat of power, Leo. So don't worry about anything. Whatever you've walked away from is probably a good thing. And right now, you may not be sleeping well, maybe still stuck and wondering if your ships will ever come in. I can assure you they are. Huge transformation coming into your life. So what should Leo let go of? What are you still holding on to that you should let go of? You should let go of looking back now, Leo. Look back, stop looking back in regret and sorrow for the things that have already been lost. Like this, look at this person, leaving 8 cups behind, moving towards their 2 of cups, right? That's what spirit wants you to do. Instead, here's a person looking behind, looking back, right, at everything that didn't work out, but spirit is saying, hey, just turn around, right behind you, hidden are those two cups that you've been looking for. Your happiness is right here. All you have to do is just turn around. So spirit is saying it's time for you to let this go. Stop looking behind, stop looking back, and all the things that were sad. Yes, all this regret and sorrow and feeling abandoned, left out in the cold, feeling lack. All that is a thing of the past. Leo, you have to let that go, because see, this is the transformation we want to bring in for you. The new life and you sitting here, taking back power and taking back control of your own life. This is what we want you to hold on and release this. Release this feeling of lack now. Enough is enough. Okay? So what's going to be Leo's biggest blockage, spirit, in June? Your biggest blockage, Leo, from what I see here, is the hermit. I think you've been keeping yourself to yourself for too long, and if you continue that way, it's going to become a blockage in your heart. You need to have communication with others. I love the way the cards just keep flowing out for you, Leo, as I'm talking. So it's saying this is going to become a blockage. Don't be in this hermit mode for too long, being by yourself. Yes, it's good to be spiritual. It's good to, you know, be living in the 5D world, but we are human beings. We have to be in the 3D world as well, right? So get out there, interact, talk, socialize, do whatever you need to change this energy around, because otherwise it's going to become a blockage, which is going to stall your future progress. One more spirit for the hermit. Why will it become a blockage? Hermit with the High Priestess. Spirit is saying you're already very intuitive. You already know the answers now. You no longer have to sit in this hermit mode. You are the sun, Leo. This is your card. This is what we've made you, Spirit is saying. Leo is represented by the sun card. This is the way we want to see you, shining bright, interacting, chatty, talking to people, and not sitting in their hermit mode. You have your hermit, your high priestess within you, right? By staying isolated doesn't make you any more spiritual. Remember that. You can be out in public, you can be on stage for all I care, and still be that high priestess, still be that hermit inside while interacting with the world, right? So you have to shine bright in June. So how do people see my Leo gang now, June spirit? They see you as the Queen of Wands. They see you shining bright, just as spirit wants, and doing very well. Maybe very involved with your family as well. But happy and comfortable and doing well, earning well. No shortage of anything. At least that's other people's perception of you. I don't know what you are in hermit mode for, but people do see you as very grounded, very comfortable in your own space, and quite happy doing that. One more as to how spirit. No wonder you've been in hermit mode, Leo. Yes, people who really love you, Leo, people who are very close to you, they also see you, the people who really know you, like from the inside, that could be your parents, could be your children, your best friend, they do know that you've been heartbroken in the past, right? But they also are seeing that it's time, Leo, it's time that you started something fresh, something exciting, something new. It's time. And that's what your loved ones are seeing you, maybe seeing you in hermit mode, and they're urging you that, hey, Leo, come on, wear your nicest outfit and let's go out, because you need to restart or re-begin living life. So, Spirit, why is the Nine of Swords your secret message for Leo? Same thing again. One more. Leo, Spirit is saying we've given you enough healing time, okay? We've given you enough healing time. Yes, we acknowledge that a tower did erupt in your life. But these towers are brought in to bring in the changes. Sometimes what happens, Leo, the universe gives us messages, gives us, it's like almost like you tell your child, do your homework, mom, I'll do it later, do your homework, I'll do it later. And then suddenly the report card comes and the child has failed, and that's a tower moment for the child, and they say, oh my God, my mom always told me, do my homework, right? So sometimes when the universe is guiding you, you don't listen, then comes in a tower moment. This tower moment brings in this change. It puts an end to the old and gives you that fresh, clean start, clean break, fresh new beginning. And Spirit is saying, yes, you have the insight now. You have been in hermit mode. We've been watching, we've been talking to you. But now it's time. It's time now not to hide your feelings or hide yourself anymore. We know what you are from the inside, and you're this passionate, fiery person. We need you to take action instead of sitting around and not being able to sleep at night, being stressed out, being tense, and still worried and thinking about the past. It's now time not to hide your emotions, but go out there and live life. Be careful, wear a mask, okay? Don't go to public places, but yes, start. You have to start living from inside before you can live on the outside, Leo. It doesn't mean going to, you know, a nightclub suddenly. No, those are closed anyway, so forget about them. It basically means you have to change your mindset from being always depressed and sad and alone and looking at the past. Instead, you have to now change it around to look towards the future. Because, okay, so that's good. Spirit, I'm going to take 3 cards for Leo's work, finance, money, and 3 cards for their love life as well. So, 3 cards for money, work, and finance, Spirit. Money, work, and finance. Thank you. The money card comes in straight shot. Okay. Ooh. All right. So, Leo, from what I see, you are getting a lot of victory, you will. In June, it's going to be a good money month from what I see. You have been working very hard, haven't you? In your, you know, hermit mode, maybe all you've been doing is working. I see one person heavily at work here. Maybe all this while, all your concentration has been on work and nothing else. You've been focusing big time. Yes, it's going to give you a lot of victory, but there's a little warning here, Leo. Don't get obsessed, please. You need to have other things to do in your life apart from only concentrating on work. It may have been something that you used to kind of, you know, get over some heartbreak. that I'm not going to think about it. I'm only going to sit by myself and do my work and do my work. Yes, that is going to give you victory. But just be a little mindful that it doesn't take over your life. It's time for you now to get out of hermit mode. That's the overall main message that I'm saying for you now. So, yes, you need to have a fulfilling life. No wonder Lord Ganesha gave you fulfillment right at the start. Right? You need to have a fulfilled life. And you have to balance everything out. So, three cards for Leo's love life now in June spirit. Three cards for Leo's love life in June. Ooh, lovers. Commitment, Two of Cups, and the Lovers. Yes, you may have to make an active choice, Leo. There is somebody available to you, I think, in June who's going to be your equal match. And maybe available to you to have a commitment with. This is going to be like that perfect God-sent partner that you're going to find now, or maybe you already have. But this is the kind of person you can have long term with. But you'll have to make a choice here, Leo. You'll have to make a choice to get out of hermit mode and accept this gift. Aries again also got the same card of the choice, but of course their choices were different. They had, I think, 3, 4, 5 people coming towards them and they didn't want any. But you are being sent a divinely guided connection here, the Two of Cups. Two of Cups with the Lovers, with the promise of commitment here. So please make the right choice, Leo, and get out of hermit mode. I've been saying that again and again to you. I think June is the month where I think things will get balanced out for you. You've already been blessed with fulfillment by Lord Ganesha. So that's wonderful to know, Leo. I hope it works for you. Let me know. Love and light. Take care. Namaste.